Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hey everyone, it's glad to see you in my English subject fifth grade school. Hopefully all of you always good and well at home. Welcome back again my English lesson unit 4 describing people. In my previous lesson, we had already discussed about personality traits. Now, I would like to tell you that this video today is our last meeting for this semester. Inshallah, for the next meeting, we have preparation class for English subject and of course for final examination the first semester. Today, I would like to continue my lesson about our topic today, describing people. Okay, everyone? Happy listening.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, everyone. Let's go to discuss about unit 4, describing people. My last previous video on my presentation last week, we had already discussed about personal traits, yeah? So now, I would like for the first to remind you about our learning points. The first is about personal traits that we had already discussed last week. And then for the second one is about adverbs of frequency. And then for the last, we also want to discuss about why you like or dislike someone. Okay, one. For the next page, I would like to remind you once more about our vocabularies. Yeah, start from calm, confident, nervous, honest, proud, brave, knowing, hardworking, impatient, unfriendly, greedy, sensible, adventurous, selfish, easygoing, and silly. So I hope all of you already knows the meaning about these vocabularies, yeah? Okay, everyone. Next, please do the exercise at home, page 34 in your workbook, yeah? Silakan dikerjakan latihannya halaman 34 untuk menambah perbendaharaan kalian, ya? Silakan dihafalkan seluruh vocabulary kita. Next, I would like to give you a listening section. Yeah, today we have a listening test. For the first one, you have to listen the audios carefully, and then after that, you have to match the letters based on the picture, and write all the answers on the answer sheet. Yeah, kita ada listening test pada hari ini. Silahkan didengarkan baik-baik audionya yang akan Bapak putarkan nanti. Kemudian tugas kalian adalah menjodohkan huruf-huruf dengan kalimat pernyataan yang disampaikan dengan menempatkan huruf-huruf tersebut ke dalam kolom bulatan putih yang sesuai dengan gambarnya. Seperti tes listening di unit 3 ya. Tulis semua jawaban kalian di lembar jawaban yang Bapak sediakan di Google Classroom. Silahkan, boleh di print ya, boleh. Atau ditulis di buku tulis juga, it's okay. So, okay, are you ready everyone? Okay, nice. Happy listening.
Hey, he looks very confident standing on that stage. B. He likes to climb trees. He's very brave. C. My friend is very nervous about riding roller coasters. D. She's always hardworking. She always completes her homework on time. E. My brother is very annoying. F. I feel so proud when I get an award. G. My friend isn't scared of anything. She is very calm. H. It's important to be honest and not take other people's things.
Okay, everyone, now let we continue our lessons. For this time, we would like to discuss about adverbs of frequency. So, you know that adverb of frequency tell us how often something take place. Ya, jadi adverbs of frequency ini pengertiannya ada seberapa sering suatu kegiatan yang kita lakukan atau peristiwa dikerjakan dalam kehidupan sehari-hari. Start from always, usually, normally, often, sometimes, occasionally, seldom, rarely, and never. Yeah. Okay, but according to your textbook, so we only focus only some few of adverbs of frequency. For example, start from always. Always, it's around 100%. It means that non-stop, yeah? For example, in sentence, he's always pray 5 times a day. In bahasa, dia selalu sholat atau berdoa 5 kali dalam sehari. Jadi, karena sholat tidak ada pernah kata tidak, jadi we should use always, ya. Okay, tanpa putus. Next, usually it's around 90%. For example, she's usually go to school on time. Yeah, it's mean that in a week, she always or she usually go to school on time. Maybe one day or 2 days. She come late, ya. Mungkin dalam seminggu dia sehari atau 2 hari datangnya terlambat. So we can use usually, and so on and so on. For example, like often, sometimes, occasionally, rarely, and never. Okay, everyone, you have to know that usually and often bisa kita artikan dengan kata selalu atau biasanya. Tergantung kadarnya yang sering kita lakukan, it's around 90% till 60%, ya. Yeah. But sometimes and occasionally, it's around 50% till 20%, ya. Yeah. Bisa kita artikan dengan maknakan kadang-kadang. And then rarely, ini artinya sudah jarang sekali. Tetapi pernah kita lakukan, mungkin hanya sekali atau 2 kali. It's around 10%, ya. Yeah. For example, like, he's rarely take a nap. Dia jarang sekali tidur siang. Or maybe, she's rarely take a breakfast. Dia jarang sekali sarapan pagi. And for the last, never. Never, it's mean that tidak pernah dilakukan sama sekali, ya. She's never tells a lie to everyone. Okay. Yeah, I hope all of you get it about adverbs of frequency, yeah. So, adverbs of frequency, we can use it for personality traits sentences, yeah. Bisa kita gunakan dalam membuat kalimat dalam personality traits juga. Okay, next, let we continue for the next lesson is about, oh, I'm sorry, there is exercise at home, page 31, yeah, you have to do it in your English book, and this is not submitted, just for exercise at home.
Silakan dikerjakan untuk latihan di rumah, ya. Okay, next, we would like to discuss why you like or dislike someone. For example, in a sentence, why do you like him? him. Him here is kata gantinya yang kedua ya. Untuk laki-laki. I like him because he is easygoing. Karena dia laki-laki, maka tubuhnya adalah he. I'm sorry, untuk subjeknya he dan tubuhnya is ya. He is easygoing. Why do you like him? I like him because he is easygoing. Kenapa kau menyukainya? Nya dia laki-laki ya. Saya menyukainya karena dia mudah bergaul atau mudah bersahabat. Next sentence. It's same with the first sentence. Hampir sama. Why do you like her? But for this time, her for woman, ya, or girl, or female. Bedanya untuk yang wanita. Oke. Blah, 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 because she is honest. Oke. Hampir sama saja jawabannya seperti yang pertama. Ya. I like her because she is honest. So her yang garis yang cetak merah, maka jangan lupa subjeknya adalah she dan tubuhnya is, seperti itu ya. So for the third sentence, it is a little bit different. Why don't you like them? Them here adalah kata ganti mereka dari kata they, ya. Oke. Why don't you like them? I don't like them. Ya, blah blah blah. They are annoying. Ya, we can answer because. Ya. Why don't you like them? I don't like them because they are annoying. Ya. Mengapa kamu tidak menyukai mereka? Saya tidak menyukai mereka karena mereka suka usil atau suka mengganggu. Oke, okay. Ya. Yeah. For the last sentence, why don't you like him? Ya, yeah, sama seperti yang kalian pertama, hanya saja ini negatif ya. Why don't you like him? Kenapa kamu tidak menyukainya? Oke, okay. Untuk yang male atau pria laki-laki ya, jangan lupa. I don't like him because he is greedy. Yeah, I don't like him. Diikuti lagi like him because he is greedy. Jangan lupa subjeknya he, tubuhnya is, and keterangannya adalah greedy. Okay, everyone, that's an example about why you like or dislike someone. It's easy, right? Okay, everyone, please do exercise at home. Ada latihannya juga. Page 35, task A and task C. It's easy, ya. Yeah? Please do at home. Okay, everyone, I think this is enough for our lesson for today, ya. Yeah? Thank you so much for attention, and then don't forget to study hard. Okay, see you again in next semester. Bye-bye.
Okay, everyone, I hope all of my presentation today, you can get a lot more about information our topic. So, once more, I would like to remind you that please study hard at home, especially for English subject, you need 3 about thinking about the past, and then you need 4 about describing people. Because these units are the materials for our last examination or final test. Okay, everyone? I think it's enough for our lesson. See you for the next semester in next year. Thank you so much for your attention. Don't forget to keep healthy and keep stay at home. See you guys in next year. And I say, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good luck, everyone.